Good morning, students. Myself, Dr. Saroj Hirnwal, working as a principal and professor at Rajasthan Institute of Engineering and Technology, Jaipur. Today, we are going to discuss about bandwidth preserving algorithms for mixed task scheduling, mixed task consisting of periodic and aperiodic tasks. In the previous slide, we have discussed about the polling server that comes under server-based algorithm and background processing. In bandwidth preserving algorithm, this is little bit different from the server-based algorithm. In this, we'll preserve the bandwidth. How they provide a mechanism for preserving the resource bandwidth server capacity allocated for aperiodic service. This is similar in spirit of that polling server, but differ in the way their server capacity is replenished or preserved. That was not associated with in the case of server-based algorithm or that polling server. The bandwidth preserving approaches provide improved response time for aperiodic task. Their bandwidth preserving algorithms are categorized into deferable server, priority exchange algorithm, extended priority exchange algorithm, and sporadic server. We'll discuss one by one in detail, but in today's session we'll discuss about the deferable server. In deferable server, we'll create a periodic server. Periodic server is nothing but a kind of periodic task with highest priority, and periodic task are associated with the capacity and the period. DS is referring as deferable server. The priority to the server is assigned according to the rate monotonic scheduling algorithm. Rate monotonic algorithm is clear to you all. Smaller the period, higher the rate. Or you can say the higher the rate, higher the priority. So we'll schedule all the task set according to the rate monotonic algorithm. And what we are doing, we are giving higher priority or highest priority to the server, that deferable server. We are creating deferable server for scheduling aperiodic task. So what we do, will keep the period minimum among all other periodic tasks so that we can easily schedule aperiodic jobs ahead of periodic jobs. The DS maintain its aperiodic execution time for the duration of this server's period. Thus, aperiodic request can be serviced at the server's highest priority at any time as long as the server's execution time CDS for the current period has not been exhausted. If the server's execution time is not used by the end of its period, the server's execution time is discarded and lost completely. The server's high priority execution time CDS is replenished to its full capacity at the beginning of its period. Let's see the example. We are considering the same data set in this example also that we have considered in background processing as well as in the polling server, that is a server based algorithm. What we have considered in that, two periodic tasks and two aperiodic tasks. Periodic task named task A and task B. A is having execution time 4 and period 10, and task B is having execution time 8 and period 20 respectively. So by observing these data set, we can analyze that task A is on higher priority as compared to task B in these two tasks, periodic tasks. Okay, now we have two aperiodic requests also. One aperiodic request arrives at time instant 5 and with execution time 1, and another arrives at time instant 12 with execution time 0.5, and we have server with capacity 1 and period 5. Okay, so things are clear to you all. I hope it is understood. So at time instant 0, there are two jobs are there in queue, job task A and task B, because they are ready at time instant 0. So in task A and task B, task A is on high priority because that is having less period. So that's why we have scheduled 0 to 4 as execution time of task 1 is 4. So 0 to 4 we have executed task A. At time instant 4, another in the ready queue only task B is there. So we have started execution of task B from 4 to 5. So what happen, we'll see the server also. Server is with capacity 1, but as there were no aperiodic job, so the capacity will remain same till 5. But at time instant 5, it is exhausted, and at time instant 5, the server again having capacity 1 as period is 5. So new data arrives at time instant 5. Okay, so at time instant 5, we received request of aperiodic job also. So we have scheduled from 5 to 6 aperiodic request and preempted job B, task B at time instant 5. Why we have preempted? Because task B is having period and task A is executing due to this deferable server, that is a kind of periodic task, but is having on highest priority as compared to this task B. So we'll see that 5 to 6 this is executed, but the capacity is 1 only, so this is turned to or exhausted, we can say, at time instant 6. The capacity of server becomes 0 from 6 to 10. And in this chart we'll see in solution that at time instant 6 again we'll resume the task B, because there is only single job in the queue, that task B, or we will execute till 10. At time instant 10, task B is also there in queue, and task A is also there in the queue, because the period was 10, and 10 to 20 again we have to execute task A. So we have started the execution at time instant 10. We have preempted task B and we have started execution of task A. 10 to 12 there is no problem, but at time instant 12 we have another job in the queue, that aperiodic request arrives with high priority. Why it's higher priority? Because its period, task A's period is 10 and the server's period is 5, so we'll preempt. So because server is with capacity 1, so we preempt the task A here and we started execution of aperiodic request 2. As aperiodic request is having execution time is 0.5 only, so we'll execute till 12 to 12.5 and the capacity reduced, the server's capacity is reduced by 0.5, as this is crystal clear from this image. So 12.5 to 15, we'll see the capacity of the server will be 0.5 only. But at time instant 15, the capacity of server again rises up to 1, as it is the highest capacity at time instant 15. So at 12.5, we again resume the execution time of task A for executing on the processor. So till 14.5 we complete the execution of task A and we resume the task B at 14.5 till the end of the execution time. So here the execution of periodic job as well as aperiodic job is over. So this is the all about this deferable server, and we'll see that how the response time of aperiodic job is improved in this. As in the polling server we have seen that at time instant 15 we were able to schedule the aperiodic request too, but here as soon as the job arrives we have scheduled. So this is the difference between polling server and bandwidth preserving algorithm, that deferable server. Thank you students, and have a nice day.